हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू न्यू वीडियो ऑफ टाइप ब्लास्टर। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी टेस्टिंग आवर पॉलीगॉन सी। इट विल बी फॉलोड बाय मैग्नेजोन एंड अ गेंगार। लेट्स सी हाउ मच टाइम वी कैन विन। वी विल बी गोइंग 5 मैचेस। सो फर्स्ट मैच, हियर द प्लेयर नेम इज टाइवन स्ट्रॉन्ग। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट डज ही हैव। ओके, अबोम स्नो। You know, Aboma Snow is good and it's quite spottable on this league. I will be farming a bit extra to give an impression of Focus Blast. I don't think he has an idea how much time it takes to reach to Focus Blast. Although I am using a Zap Cannon, but he doesn't know it. Okay, attack and defense fall. Now he is using his Weather Ball. I am shielding. I think he will reach his feather ball before I reach to next attack. Okay, he has already reached, as you can see. I will not block it. Okay, feather ball. Okay, fine. I will be using the try attack first. Now what I will do is form a bit and then when he will be about to hit me with his feather ball, I will just make an escape swap to the Magnezone. Okay, nice. I did it. Ice type feather ball is not a problem on Magnezone. Okay, easy, nice. Thank you. Next. Okay, so here is a Poliwreath. I have to be careful with the dynamic punch. It's too early for a dynamic punch. I think I will not shield. Yes, as expected, it's an ice punch. I will be going for the wild charge directly because I know I can hit 2 wild charges before he reaches to his dynamic punch. Yes, he didn't even shield. Okay, nice. Aboma Snow mirror shot. Because my defense is hastily fallen, as you can see. I am not taking risk of even a weather ball. Okay, Togekiss, nice. I will hit with a mirror shot. It's a wild charge. Please block it, block it, please block it. Okay, nice, well done. I will just bring the Gengar and hit them with a sludge bomb. At this point, I don't really need to shield, but I'm still shielding. An ancient power or even a flamethrower will not knock out the Gengar, but still shielding. Okay, so we have won our first match. Okay, nice. Finished. We have won our first match with 2 Pokemons left. Now starting our second battle. Player name is Inas Kiaye, something like that. Maybe some Japanese name. Can't spell it. Empoleon. Okay, now I tell you how to cope with Empoleon in these matches. What you have to do is go to Zap Cannon. I mean, form up to Zap Cannon, not really use it. Now I'm shielding it. Now I will immediately hit with the try attack. To give an impression that I am hitting with the Zap Cannon. Yes. I even took an extra waterfall, as you saw. Now they will block it most probably. Yes, they did. Now I just have to go to Zap Cannon. I mean, we can't hit with Zap Cannon at first because, you know, Zap Cannon takes more than Hydro Cannon to get built. It takes more time. So that's why. You will just be losing the race to race to the fast attack, I mean charge attack. Bringing the Magnezone. Okay, I will just go to wild charge and hit it. It is because I want that last shield from them. Now immediately bringing the Gengar and forming to shadow punches. I will not go for sludge bomb because it takes a bit longer. एंड चारिजार्ड इज लोडेड ऑन एनर्जी मेनली. ओके दे डिडंट हैव अ शील्ड आइदर. आई एम शील्डिंग इट. नाउ आई विल जस्ट ट्राई टू गो टू द शेडो पंच बिफोर दे रेस्ट टू देयर नेक्स्ट ड्रैगन क्लो. एक्चुअली दे हैव रेस्ट बट दे वर ट्राइंग टू ओवरफॉर्म. That's nice, we hit it. I don't think this Luffy will be able. Okay, they actually left the game. Anyways, I would have won. Okay, nice, we have won our second battle. Now we move to the third battle. Let's see, guys. Luis Gurula 04, that's a player name. Okay, Dragonite versus Porygon Z. Many of you might be wanting to see this because Dragonite is often spotted on lead on the Ultra League. I race to try attack before the Dragonite reaches to its Dragon Claw. I know it. Also, defense and attack fail. I will shield it because they are also shielded. But you see, Dragon Breath, Porygon Z is almost about 60% left now, but Dragonite is more than 80%. I am not shifting. Gengar is squishy, so although it resists the attack of this Venusaur, but I am still holding to this the Porygon. I will shield it. You know, Venusaur is so tanky, still it is hitting so hard on it. Yes, I saved the try attack on Porygon. Now either they shield or they give their Venusaur with the energy. Okay, they decided to give the Venusaur. I will just try to go to Shadow Punch before them. Yes, I did. Okay, this is really very nice. They will not shield it, I guess. Oh, they did shield. They knew it was a shadow punch. Still, they did shield because I don't have shield, so they thought they can. Now I will just bring the Porygon and hit the with the try attack. That is why I did save the energy. It takes so less time to rest to try attack, and this is just. It hit so hard, you know. I'm taking the Magnezone inside. The problem is Lapras is so tanky. I don't think even a wild charge will eliminate the Lapras. I don't know if I can win this. A wild charge may or may not knock the Lapras. Okay, I am hitting. Let's see. Yes, as expected, I didn't knock it. Had let me hit with the mirror shot. No. Defense has fallen this much. I'm sure it will just eliminate the Magnezone. Yes, it did. Now, Porygon, can it? No. Porygon also left. This was a kind of tragedy with us. I will not count it in a lose, but. You can see the difference of life was very less. Problem with Porygon is it basically do negligible damage with the first moves. Lock-on is very weak. Okay, Swampert. Now we have to keep counting its mudshot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now it's ready. Its Hydro Cannon is ready. Okay, they took it. Now I will not shield, I think, because attack has fallen, as you saw. It will take only 4. He has hit 3, now it's 4th. Yes, I have to shield, otherwise I die with the energy I have. I am shifting to Gengar immediately. to hit it with a shadow punch. Now if they don't shield, it will knock out the Swampert. Yes, they didn't shield. They have two shields, we have three Pokemons. I have to be careful with the net slash of Scizor. Night Slash is super effective because of being dark and it forms the Night Slash so quickly. I don't think I will risk a second Shadow Punch. Yes, leave second. I didn't even hit one more Shadow Claw. Okay, so knocked out. I didn't shield because I don't think it was worth it. Now I will just. I can't go to Wild Charge. Wild Charge will make the defense fall so much. Night Slash, neutral damage. Mirror Shot, it will also not knock out. I will just try to form it down with my sparks only. Yes, I succeeded. Last Pokemon was that. Okay. I will just try to go for two Wild Charges and then one Zap Cannon because the Porygon Z is about 75% loaded to try attack. Because they had two shields, okay, they didn't block. Wow, that was disgusting. Okay, anyways, we have won our third battle. We have basically won three battles out of four. Now we are moving to our fifth battle. Player name is Toy5150. Basically, let's see what do they have. It's Lapras versus Porygon Z. Okay, nice. I will try to form. Okay, they shifted to their Dragonite. I will hit with the Tri-Attack first before going to Magnezone. Now I will try to make an escape swap. Will they shield it? Yeah, no, they didn't. Okay, I succeeded in making the escape swap. Nice. Dragon Claw is not a problem here. Mirror Shot is more than sufficient to knock out this Dragonite. Dragonites in Ultra League are not so tanky as they are in Master. Okay, here is a Toxicroak. Here is a quick tip, guys. If there are so much, if people are bringing fighting types frequently, do not keep Magnezone with the Porygon Z. In such case, two Pokemons will be weak to fighting. If this happens, then keep a Charmer. Do not keep Psychic also, because if you do that, two Pokemons will become weak to Dark type. Now I only have one shield left. I have to be careful with the Mud Bomb. I don't need to worry about the fast move, the counter. Okay. Now their Mud Bomb here. Now they don't have energy left. Now it's a race who reaches to the fast move quicker. I raced to the Shadow Punch before them, so it is nice. This eliminated our Toxicroak. Now there is the Lapras. Okay, I have to race to the Zap Cannon quickly. Don't hit me with Surf, please don't hit. Yes. Nice, I made it to Zap Cannon and this will obviously knock out the Lapras, no doubts. Basically, Zap Cannon is powerful than Wild Charge, as you all might know. You can also keep a Focus Blast on the Porygon Z, it's not a problem. In fact, I think Focus Blast will be doing better. I don't know, I can't go back. Yes, Panda. It's a Niantic bug. But as you guys saw, we have won 4 matches and 1 lose. I don't even consider it lose, as you saw that Lapras had very less life remaining. Okay guys, thanks for watching. Please do like and subscribe the video. I am trying to show you all 5 matches but can't But you have seen, we have won 4. Tratech is really very good. Thank you. Goodbye. Please like and subscribe the video and keep notifications on. Happy